I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting.
So sorry,
you say
smartest guy you ever faced in sparring or fighting? Who is like super intelligent in the ring? Like, you know, they say some fighters have very high IQ.
Yeah. I don't know, because you know, like when I go into sparring sessions, I normally have a very high IQ myself, and I'm probably the fastest guy in boxing. So when I mean, it's hard to say. You know, sometimes you get these amateur kids who probably don't even have a name, like a big name yet, who are probably more dangerous because they have nothing to lose and they're just going in the ring with you and throw some fast shots and some powerful shots go in as well. And they're very experienced, but they just never make it to that next level. But they might be good sparring partners, but they'll never be good fighters. So yeah, it just depends really. But I've sparred a lot of people, and even in the UK, you know, sparred with like world champions. And but I've just not, never, it's hard to say. Like, I mean, I have to say Manny Pacquiao is probably one of the best I've sparred with. But other than that, I've not really sparred with any world champions. I've trained with a lot, but I've never sparred with any guys up there.
How about who had the most freakish power that you ever sparred or fought?
You know who had a lot of power? Was, remember, Benavides?
Yeah.
Was it Benavides? Had a lot of power.
You guys did a lot of sparring.
We did a lot of sparring. I was like 135 then as well, and about 135 and 140. And I think he was fighting around in camp around 140 as well. I mean, he was strong. And he had that, you know what made him stronger was that long, wiry range he had. And shooting them shots in long and like a Tommy Hearns style he had. He was tall and bam, bam.
He has a great story right now.
Yeah, he made a comeback.
He got shot, you know that? He got shot in the leg.
No way.
I've talked to him about this. Yeah, he got shot in the leg numerous times. Ah. Came back this year, won in a very convincing way. So 2-3 more fights. He and Crawford got into it. They were yelling at each other.
Oh, really? So I remember his brother who's a world champion now.
Yeah.
What's his name? David.
David, yeah.
David was a short, fat kid in the gym.
250 pounds. Now he's 168.
And we see him in the gym. Lovely guy he was.
Yeah.
And look at how he's come on and become a great fighter and become a world champion. But yeah, Benavides, his dad was there also coaching him and helping him out as well.
Very nice guy.
But yeah, you know, good family, good people. I mean, they helped me a lot in training when I was getting ready for a lot of fights. But the kid was strong. And yeah, he has come from a crazy story. He's had the last couple of years for him have been very difficult. But I'm happy to see him back in the ring.
Doctors told him you're not going to walk.
Really?
And now he's doing his thing, and you know.
Is he gonna fight again then?
Yeah, he fought recently and won.
Did he?
And then afterwards, he got into it with Crawford.
Wow, so he wants to fight. Is he still campaigning at 147? Or
yep, 147. He really wants Crawford.
Wow, and he's stronger. I mean, look, he's very strong. You can feel his power through this 49ers gloves. I mean, let alone when he wears 8 or 10.
Yeah, no, he won by knockout.
So there you have it, another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach, reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter, @Seckbach. And you can follow me on Instagram, @Elie Seckbach.